recognized only by a feeling of emptiness or loneliness when we first get seen. This has one of the most difficult aspects of addiction, of course, because this part of our disease affects us so profoundly, so personally. We may be overwhelmed when we think about applying a program of recovery. However, we need to keep in mind that recovery doesn't happen overnight for everyone. As we start to look at the effects of our disease, we sure to see that our lives have become unmanageable. We see it in all the things that are wrong with our lives. Again, our experiences are individual and vary widely from addict to addict. Some of us realize our lives have become unmanageable because we felt out of control, emotionally overwhelmed, we feel guilty about our drugs. Some of us have lost everything, our home, our family, jobs, and our self-respect. Some of us never learned how to function as human beings at all. Some of us have spent time in jails and institutions, and some of us have come very close to death. Whatever our individual circumstances, our lives have been governed by our choices and both of self-seeking behavior and the end result has been unmanageability. Perhaps we arrive in an age without recognizing the problems we hold or what they were. Because of our self-consciousness, we're often the last point to realize that we were addicts. Many of us were persuaded by friends or family to begin spending and even more. Other members received even stronger encouragement from support. No matter how it occurred, our long-standing belief on past experience shattered. Honesty has become the most important to face the truth of our addiction.
Many of us recall moments of clarity when we come face to face with our dreams. All lives that we dream that we are just not aware we stood at the moment of truth about the world. We have found that we could not recover without the ability we are. Many of our teams have spent years practicing the law. However, we can learn beyond the because, you know, I think both of us want to fucking high on acid right now in New York, right?
You
just sure, you don't know me. I'm a bad influence. Given a choice between finding a new life in NA and continuing our addiction recovery begins to feel. The first time, when I saw Mike, I had a year, he had a year and 2 months. I used to drink all the last time, now, you know, the turn, the table turn, right? Well, we don't get drunk. That was the only time we met. I know it's not.
Page 10, it works. Our long step back. Begin to let go of our reservations, those parts of ourselves we know, and long surrender to the program. Most of us do have some reservations. Even so, we need to find ways of addressing them. Reservations can be anything. A belief that because we never had a problem, we want a particular drug, we still use it. Such a condition on our recovery. Such as only staying clean as long as our expectations are met. Belief that we still can be involved with people associated with our addiction. A belief that we can use again after a certain amount of time clean. A conscious or unconscious decision to